All right, yogis, welcome to a yin class. I hope you've got your cushions, blocks, bells, whatever it is you need. Just take a minute to settle down on your mats. Sit cross-legged, Sukhasana, Vajrasana, whatever works for you. Increase the length of your spine. Rest your palms on your knees. Gently close your eyes. And try and come back to the present moment. So leave the rest of the day where it was in the past. Don't worry too much about what's going to happen. It's not yet happened. And instead, just focus on the here, on the now, on your breath. My intention is to lead a yin class. And most of you have done yin before. You take a pause and then just hold the stillness with that pause. Allow gravity to work into your tissues. Allow your fascia to stretch, allow your muscles to stretch. And just keep relaxing into the pose. When you're ready, gently blink your eyes open, interlace your fingers, inhale all the way to the top, stretch, gently stretch through, exhale, circle your arms behind you, interlace your fingers, squeeze your shoulder blades, extend your elbows, and then take your heart up. We keep relaxing your knees down. So nice little back bend. Go nice and slow, nice and easy. And slowly release. Interlace your fingers in front of you. Round your back. Imagine someone's pulling your arms out of the shoulder sockets. Keep rounding your back. Stick your chin in towards your chest and slowly release your palms to the floor. Take your time, it's yin. No rush, nowhere to be, nothing to do. Slowly come back tall, left palm outside right knee, right palm behind, inhale, spine tall, exhale, twist. Take your time to get into your fullest twist possible. And release the other side. Right palm outside left knee, left palm behind. Inhale, spine tall, exhale, twist. And release. Stick your right palm to your right, inhale your left palm up, lateral bend, stick your left hip further into the mat as you reach across with your left palm. Maybe spiral your heart up towards the ceiling. And release, left palm to left side, inhale, right palm up. And lateral bend on the other side. Push your right hip into the mat. Maybe circle your heart up towards the ceiling. And release. Circle your shoulders up, back and down. Two or three times. And then reverse. Back up. and forwards. And release. So let's start with a slightly more demanding posture. Keep your left foot forward a little to the left and support yourself on your palms and walk your right knee as far back as it will go. Now you can choose to stay here. If you want to increase the stretch, keep pushing your tailbone down and forward, climb up onto your left knee. And you can choose to stay here. If your right knee is feeling a little funky, you can fold your mat, so increase the cushion on your right knee. If you find this is not demanding enough, you can actually twist to the right and reach your right fingertips behind your right knee and keep slowly, gently walking your fingertips back. But I'm going to stay here. And as you know, this is yin. So we'll hold this for about 2 to 3 minutes. Use this time to go within, see what's stretching. At some point, your right psoas, which is stretching, will say, oh, please get out, please give up. And that's when you start your mental gymnastics. Who or what is asking you to move? Do you absolutely need to move? Can you hold your stillness? Can you hold your peace? Can you release the tension from whichever muscle doesn't require the tension? For example, your abs, your shoulders, your neck. Then can you slowly deepen your breath? And with each deepening breath, can you keep pushing your tailbone down and forward? So just giving in to gravity. Maybe gently closing your eyes. Maybe just focusing on the different sensations around your hips. Maybe just accepting the intense stretch on your right hip flexor without judgment and saying, you know, this too shall pass. And instead of focusing on the pain, focus on the pleasure. Say, yes, let me enjoy this while it lasts. Feel free to support yourself, maybe put an arm down if it gets too intense. And then slowly release to child's pose. Take your time. Keep your knees together to start with and slowly release your forehead down to the mat. Relax your arms by your sides. When you're ready, slowly make your way back to seated. And this time, get your right foot forward. Keep your palms down to start with. Walk your left knee as far back as you can. Keep pushing your hips down and forward. Maybe leave your palms down, maybe climb up onto your right knee. And if you feel so inclined, continue to push your hips down and forward. Take your left palm behind your left knee and walk your fingertips back as much as you can. So it's your choice how intense you want to make this. But wherever you are, cultivate a sense of stillness, a sense of meditation. Recognize that pain in the stretch. Recognize that slight feeling of discomfort. And yet decide to enjoy it. Yet decide not to do anything about it. Yet decide not to react. And instead, hold your peace. Hold your stillness. Despite that intense sensation. That slight pain might actually be good for you. We often don't realize this in life, but pain can actually be good if you can handle it well. And this yin practice gives you the time and space to practice handling pain. Here it's at a physical level. Pain could equally be emotional, sorrow, heartbreak, betrayal, confusion, anger, jealousy. Can we remain silent, just experience it and let it pass? Make sure your tailbone is releasing down and forward with gravity. When you're ready, slowly release back to child's pose. Take your time. So there's an enormous resistance to movement now. Use your time. Try and keep your knees together and slowly lower yourself to child's pose. Slowly find yourself back up and then move to a Sphinx pose. So you need to keep your elbows below your shoulders. Your elbows are shoulder width apart. Spread your palms, your fingers on the mat and gently, just gently keep pushing your heart between your upper arms. Everything else is relaxed. You don't have to jerk your chin up or tuck it in. Just keep your neck a natural extension of your spine. Look forward between your palms and a little ahead. Or if you want, go ahead, close your eyes. And just deal with the sensation of gently pushing your heart forward between your upper arms. See if you can keep your shoulders away from the ears. So rather than sink in like this, just minimal amount of muscular effort to keep your shoulders away from your ears and push the heart gently forward. So without that push, it's a very subtle thing, but you're gonna lose that tension. So keep that little tension in your abs and compression in your middle and lower back. Close your eyes if you want to. Stay with your breath. Deepen your inhales, deepen your exhales. And when you're ready, slowly lower yourself down. But if you can, just watch your screen. So this is what's going to happen. Keep your right leg straight. Bend your left knee so that your left hip is at right angles, your left knee is at right angles. And then palm over palm, get your left knee closer to your left elbow, closer to your left knee. But stick your right hip where it is. Don't let the hip kind of move. Then let your right palm follow and just keep your right cheek on the back of your right palm. So you're giving a gentle stretch to the right side of your torso. Settle in. There's a gentle compression on the left side of your torso and a gentle stretch on the right side. Feel the heaviness of your physical being on your chest and your stomach. Deep breather, breathe deeper into the back of your lungs. See if you can feel yourself floating on the mat. See if you can remove even the frown lines from your forehead and slowly release to the other side. So come back to neutral. Extend your left leg fully behind you. Bend your right knee this time. And then slowly get your right elbow down towards your right knee as much as you can without moving your left hip. Stick your left hip where it is. And then rest your left cheek on the back of your left palm. Enjoy the stretch on the left side of your torso. Allow gravity to pull your right hip down towards the mat. Deepen your breath. While you feel your weight on the mat, see if you can use your breath to get a sense of floating on the mat. Release whatever muscles you don't need. Pay attention to your glutes, your hamstrings, your quads. Relax your right glutes. Focus on the breath. Breathe deeper on the back of your lungs. And slowly release back to center. Palm on top of palm. Enjoy the rebound. Just completely relax in your crocodile. Now slowly move towards your quads. So this is the easy option. So this is level one. Just bend your knees in, hold on to your toes, keep your knees in towards each other and gently push your heels into your glutes. As long as you're feeling a stretch on your quads, great. So that's level one. If you want level two, get into Vajrasana and then walk your palms behind and then see if you can get down to your elbows. As long as you feel a stretch on your quads, that's all that you're looking for. So that's level two. And if you want to go deeper into level three, walk your shoulders all the way down. And completely give it. You can leave your palms next to you on your stomach, or if you want a little stretch on your torso, take your palms above your head. So make a choice, yogis. We're gonna hold this for a bit. Quad stretches always help for a little longer. Enjoy. Try to minimize movement. deepen your breath. If you're rolling your stomach, breathe more into the back of your lungs. If you're on your elbows, breathe evenly through the lungs. If you're on your back like me, breathe more into the front of your lungs. Good. Focus your attention on the stretch in your quads. Focus also on the compression in your lower back. Gravity wherever you are. When you're ready, slowly, gently ease yourself out of the position. Take your time and just move to seated. Very slowly, just move to seated. Stay in seated for a bit because that was an extreme compression on your lower back. And then slowly release to child's pose. Take your time. You'll feel sensations on your lower back. Enjoy those sensations. Slowly make your way back to seated. Release your feet from under you. Extend your knees in front of you. And then keeping your right knee straight, bend your left knee to the left side, left foot on right thigh, and slowly just fall forward. You can keep a block beneath your hips to elevate your pelvis so you get a nice little forward tilt. And then just allow gravity to pull you down. That's it. So there's no pulling, there's no pushing, there's only gravity releasing you down. So initially, your lower back might feel jammed and tight. Just breathe. With each breath, let gravity pull your heart lower, pull your head lower. So you're not really pushing yourself into any position. You're just allowing gravity to do its work. If you keep your knees straight, you'll feel the stretch in your right hamstring. And as you breathe, and as you lower, that stretch becomes ever so intense. Then you might reach a point where you feel you can't go anymore. So then just hang in there and breathe. And then see if you can relax a little more. And maybe lower yourself a little more. Yin is about giving in, not about resisting, but just giving in, not only to gravity, but also to your to the limits of your body's flexibility. So if you feel stuck, just accept it. Give in to that limitation. Don't push beyond. Very often you find gentleness will allow you to go deeper rather than brute force. So it is with life. Very often gentleness allows you access to people and events that you could only dream of. Use your breath to go heavy, to sink, to yield. Slowly release, lie down on your back in Shavasana, very gently, take your time. See if you feel you've got a different left leg and a different right leg from different bodies. Feel the sensations in your lower back. Maybe your hamstrings. Those are the sensations of the rebound. It's just your body resetting. Relax as much as you can. Melt into the mat. Get your heels together, get your big toes together, point your toes forward, lift your heels 10 inches off the mat, and then as you slowly get your feet down, raise your heart up, come to seated, and then keep your left leg straight, bend your right knee out to the side, right foot against left thigh, maybe remove the flesh from underneath, and gently fold forward. Same thing on the left side. So use your breath. No need to keep your spine tall. Just go humble. Just release down with your breath. Round your shoulders, no matter. Round your back, don't care. Just give in to gravity. think of it as a journey with stops. The stops are when you feel tight, when you feel tired. You take a break. Then use your breath and see if you can let go of a few more muscles. And you'll be surprised that by letting go, you can actually go ahead with your journey. Take your time. There's no goal. There's no set point. As long as you feel the stretch, as long as you keep giving in to gravity, that's all that matters. Each one's pose will look different depending on your specific body. So there's nothing to compare to except how you feel internally. Slowly release onto your back into Shavasana. Slowly take your time. Completely relax. Let the mat absorb all the sensations in your lower back, in your upper back, in your hamstrings. And all you do is breathe and allow those sensations to course through. The beauty of those sensations is they don't let you interfere. They just come and they go. Maybe the same should be with life. Let it flow through you rather than resist and put up a defense and guide your life in a particular way. Maybe the wiser thing might be to just let it flow. When you're ready, bend your knees, get your feet on the mat, get your heels as close to your hips as possible, and then get your right knee over your left knee, so cross it. And by crossing, I mean cross it really close. Don't do this. Cross your right knee over your left, and then drop both your knees to the left. So right over left, and then both your knees to the left. And then stretch your arms out on either side. And maybe turn your head to look over your right shoulder. And enjoy your twist. This time, use your breath to ease into the twist. With each exhale, see if your right knee can drop further down to the floor. Next exhale, see if your right shoulder can reach the floor. As you deepen your breath, you realize you're breathing more into your right lung than your left. Keep yielding to gravity, especially your right knee. Deepen your breath. Slowly just come back up, but keep that cross, right knee on top of left knee, and slowly drop both your knees over to the right. And then maybe turn your head to look over your left shoulder. See if you can keep dropping both your knees down to the floor. Use your breath to work with gravity rather than against gravity. Try and keep your left shoulder on the mat. Feel the stretch on the left side of your torso. Try to hold your stillness. Try to go within. Slowly release back to Shavasana. Take your time. Twists can become very intense. So just let it go into your Shavasana. bend both your knees in again. Keep your feet on the mat, close to your hips. This time, get your left knee crossing over the right. And slowly release both your knees down to the right. Try and keep your left shoulder on the mat. Deepen your twist by taking your left knee closer to the mat. Use your breath. Maybe turn your face over your left shoulder. Release all the muscles you don't need to tighten. Check your calves, check your glutes. Check your obliques, let it go. Stay with your breath. Twists are a great time to go within. Increase the length of your inhales, increase the length of your exhales. Fill your lungs up even more. And then slowly come back to center, take your time. Maintain the cross of the left knee over the right and drop both your knees over to the left. Then look over your right shoulder if you need to. Final twist. Feel the stretch of the right side of your torso. Use your breath to keep your knees getting heavy with gravity. Focused on the stretch or the compression, and then not react to it and just recognize it for what it is, a sensation. Try not to attach a label like painful or pleasurable. Just recognize it for what it is, a sensation. And then see if you can disconnect the sensation from where you feel it. The sensation is recognized in your brain, but felt in the glute, in the dorsal. Slowly release and come back to Shavasana. Extend your knees, completely relax. Hug. Gently rock from side to side. Roll over to your left. Turn your face down. Come up to seated very slowly. And then come to the rear end of your mat. Keep your knees about hip width apart. Stay on your knees. And then keep your hips above your knees at all times. We're going to do the spinal bridge. So keep your hips above your knees. Come down to your elbows. Keeping your hips above your knees, walk your elbows as far forward as possible. And then see if you can rest your forehead, your chin, or even your heart on the mat. Make sure your hips remain above your knees. When you're ready, just settle down. You want to increase the stretch on your triceps, bend your elbows, get into Namaste, and get your Namaste behind your neck. But with each breath, release your heart down towards the mat. With each inhale, relax all the muscles you don't need, your glutes, your hamstrings, your quadriceps, your calves. Don't even tighten your navel in towards your spine. Let it loose. Compression in your upper back, maybe middle back, and a nice little stretch on the front of your torso, your abs especially. And if you're like me, with your elbows bent, your triceps should be feeling a nice little stretch too. Up your quads, relax. With each exhale, see if your heart can grow heavier towards the mat. find your stillness, and through your stillness, find your now. And in your now, find your peace. Slowly release with depth, no quick movements, and just get into a little bit of a child's pose. Won't hold it for long, just a nice little child's pose. Relax your shoulders, relax your arms. And then if you wish to stay in your child's pose, if you wish, move to Shavasana on your back, whatever works for you today. When you feel ready, slowly, very slowly make your way to seated. Sit wherever is comfortable. Get your palms in front of your heart. Relax your shoulders, lengthen your spine. Gently bow your head to your namaste. This is your final moments of stillness before you ease your way back into your normal daily routine. See if you can fully experience that sense of stillness, that sense of peace, that sense of just being without labeling, without judging, that sense of being able to tolerate pain, that sense of being able to take the good with the bad, and just fully embrace that for a minute. And then see if you can resolve to take that sense of stillness, that sense of being non-judgmental, that sense of being able to take the good and bad with you in your daily life as you go about your business. Yes, you will feel pain, you will feel joy, but see if you can remain unaffected by it. Gently blink your eyes open. Keep your shoulders away from your ears. Gently drop your right ear to your right shoulder. Come back to the center. Drop your left ear to your left shoulder. Come back to the center. Namaste, yogis. As always, great to practice with you. Hope you enjoyed the yin. And I'm serious about taking that yin with you in your lives. Lives are frantic anyway. I'll stop the recording now.